Hello friends, today we are going to see the exercise of chapter 2, preamble to the constitution of our civic subject. We will see all answers of questions from the exercise which is given in textbook. The question number 1 is, find the following words in a grid. So we have to find some words from this grid or from this table, and we have given the clues here. A sense of way feeling and empathy towards fellow citizens means the meaning of a sense of way feeling and empathy towards fellow citizens is called fraternity. So we have to find fraternity in this grid. Let us see where is the fraternity in this grid. You can find fraternity here. You can find fraternity right here. Fraternity. See, FRATERNITY. Fraternity. The next question is, a system in which sovereign power in the hands of the people. In which system or in which governing system the power is in the hands of people, that system is called democracy. That system is called democracy. And then we will get the democracy word right here in the grid. You can see here my cursor or my pointer, democracy, D-E-M-O-C-R-A-S-Y, democracy. Next question, third, introduction to the constitution. The introduction to the constitution is called preamble. The introduction to the constitution is called as preamble. Then where will we get preamble? The word preamble. We have to find the word preamble and we will get the preamble word right here. Preamble. Preamble means the introduction to the constitution. Then the next word. A system in which all religions are considered equal. The system in which all religions are equal are called, is called, this system is called secular system. Then we will find the word secular right here. You can see here S-E-C-U-L-A-R, secular. This was our first question. Let us see next question, question number 2. Answer the following questions. What are the provisions in a secular constitution? What are the provisions in a secular constitution? And the answer is, following provisions are in the secular constitution. Provisions means laws, and provisions are given in our secular constitution. No one religion is considered to be the state religion. Our state not belong to any particular religion. The citizens are free to follow their own religion. There are so many religions in our country, and every citizens of each religion is free to follow his own religion. State cannot discriminate among citizens on the basis of religion. These are the provisions in a secular constitution. Means there is no discrimination among the citizens on the basis of religion. Means Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai. And the state don't do any discrimination among the citizens on the basis of this religion. The question number 2 is, what is meant by adult franchisee? And the answer is, we have adopted universal adult franchisee to enable equal participation in the running of the country. We all have equal participation or right of equal participation in the running of country or in the government. We all have equal right or equal participation. Accordingly, all citizens completing 18 years of age have the right to vote in elections. How many years, friend? 18 years age. The children which are smaller than 18 years, they do not cast their vote or they do not vote in elections. But when they are grown-ups at 18 years old, they have the right to vote in the elections. Means 16 years children do not give their votes in elections. The question number 3 is, what rights does economic justice ensure? Economic justice ensures the right to a source of livelihood so as to look after oneself and oneself family. Our constitution has given this every citizen without any discrimination. Here there is constitution, not institution. This is the printing mistake. Our constitution has given this every citizen without any discrimination. Means every and each citizen has right to work and right to look after their family and to earn for their family. This is the economic justice ensured. Every citizen has the right to earn for their family and for themselves. Question number 4. How will human dignity be established in a society? Human dignity means, human dignity will establish in a society by giving equal respect to each other, each individual as human being. Human dignity means give value to each humans and to give respect to each others, and this will establish in a society by giving the equal respect to each other. Not only respect, here equal respect to each other or each individual as a human, not as an animal. Each and every citizen should be respected in our country. That is why, and after that, human dignity will establish in our country. Human dignity will establish only when there is no discrimination upon criteria of caste, creed, race, sex, language, etc. Human dignity will establish only when there is no discrimination. Human dignity is established only without discrimination. And in our country, in old age, there were discrimination in our country on the basis of caste, creed, race, sex and language. But if we have to maintain or establish human dignity, we don't discriminate humans in the criteria given here. Question number 3. How should we make use of our freedom? Write your views about it. Friends, this is the personal response questions, and the answer of this question is different from different students, and different student has different views. So I have not given here this square answer. You have write your own answer. It will be correct. Question number 4. Explain the following concepts. Socialist state. A socialist state is such a state where the gap between rich and poor is minimum. This is the characteristic of socialist state. There is no gap between the rich and the poor. There is no gap between rich and poor. Why there is no gap between rich and poor? Because all people have equal means of earning or income. So there is no rich and poor gaps in this socialist state. There is no gap because rich have same income, because all peoples have same income or means of equal income, so there is no gap. All have right over the wealth of country. All have right here have. All have right over the wealth of the country. It is initiated that will it is not concentrated in the hands of few people. we can see in our country, the wealth of our country is in the hands of only few people. We call them rich people, and some people do not have wealth. They are not wealthy. We call them poor people. This is the characteristics of socialist state. Equality. The preamble guarantees the Indian citizens and equality of status and opportunity. In our country, our preamble gives the guarantee of equality of status and opportunity. In our country, all have same status and same opportunity to develop themselves. The guarantee of equal status means not to discriminate between people in terms of high, low, superior, inferior. Means there is no discrimination like high, low, superior and inferior in our country. There is equality. The preamble has given great importance to equality of opportunity as well. Our preamble has given importance to equality of opportunity. Means all have equal chance to develop themselves. That is called equality to opportunity. Next, sovereign state. The word sovereign means that a state is not under the control of foreign power. Like our India is not under the control of any other foreign country. Sovereignty means the ultimate authority to govern yourself. In a democracy, sovereignty rests with the people. The constitution reflects the principle of popular sovereignty, and the government elected by the people makes laws on behalf of people. Means our country does not control of any other foreign countries. Our citizens or our people have sovereignty rest with them. Our people have power to rule them. Our people or our citizens have rights to rule them or to rule the country. The constitution reflects the principle of popular sovereignty, and government elected by the people makes laws on behalf of the people. Means people elect the government and government make laws on the behalf of people. Or for the people. They do not any other foreign country make laws for our country. Our government or our people make laws for our country, and that is the characteristics of sovereign state. Equality of opportunity. The preamble has given one great importance to equality of opportunity as well. All will get opportunities for development without any discrimination. The preamble has given one great importance to equality of opportunity as well. All will get the opportunities for development without any discrimination. That is the principle of equality of opportunity. Friends, this was our exercise. You have to write it in your notebook. Thank you.